So this case had so many different layers to it. I mean, you've got murder by poisoning, you've got embezzlement, fancy cars and houses. I mean, it's almost made like a Hollywood script. Did any of it surprise you?
It's a bit China's Macbeth in a way. Did it surprise me? Well, obviously, when you hear the sort of the full-bodied, lurid detail of this particular case, it's pretty shocking. But it's widely accepted in China that many public officials are quite corrupt when it comes to sexual dalliance, embezzlement, property abroad. Everybody knows businessmen are paying for tickets for kids of officials to go to school, paying their tuition, all of this sort of stuff. And in fact, the party now has launched a massive campaign against corruption. So we know this is a problem. They're frightened of it because it is giving them a reputation that they can ill afford to sustain.
And what are the consequences of that for, say, for example, companies wanting to do business in China? This is sort of standard practice that the wheels have to be greased.
You know, American companies, because of the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act, sometimes complain that they're at a disadvantage because they are not allowed to grease the wheels. On the other hand, the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act helps them because, in effect, Chinese officials have come to accept largely that Americans cannot play that game. So it's a kind of a curious double-edged sword.
So what are you watching for in the next few months and possibly years as this case goes forward?
Well, China is in the throes right now of a rather pronounced crackdown against all sorts of sort of dissenting energy. There's very narrow margins now where people can sort of disagree. It's harder to seek any redress of grievance. And this is sort of its old manner. When things get tough, you control, you tighten down. But I think in the modern world, this is going to be less and less effective.
And when it comes to corruption in China, how significant of a factor are the social media sites, or I should say Weibo, the equivalent of Twitter that we have here? I mean, you almost see on a daily basis people documenting accounts of corruption now.
Well, Weibo, Weixin, which are the social media vectors, this is what's really different about China today. And the party's having a heck of a time with this to know what it should do. It wants to control them. It does. But they're basically difficult to control. They're so decentralized in many ways. So we're looking at a Petri dish in which a very interesting experiment is going on between an old-style Leninist party who's used to control and this new style, very sort of hectic, chaotic, spontaneous form of communication that is making for a tremendous amount of anxiety high in the leadership circles of China.
Orville Schell, thanks so much.
Pleasure.